upon a time, there was a town in Austria where they found a lot of iron ore a few hundred years ago. I mean, there's even legends about the devil giving... Oh no, it's not the devil, it's an Aquarius they captured from their lake. And to set him free, they had to choose between finding gold for a year, silver for 10 years, or iron ore forever. And the Eisenerz people decided, long-term thinking, sustainability, we choose the iron ore. And in the reality, you have a valley with a town and a mountain behind it that now is only half a mountain, because they are just since a few hundred years they're taking out the mountain to find the iron ore. They had their nice employment and efficiency peak during the Nazi time, where Eisenerz produced a quarter of the whole German iron ore production. And then till the 70s it was still quite an active quarry, and from there it went down. They still take out the same amount of iron ore, but they don't need people anymore because it's rather machines. So in the end, iron ore had, Eisenerz still had 15,000 inhabitants around 30 years ago. Now it has 4,000. It's one of these cities that is a bit sad and empty, but at the same time, as usually, has quite a lot of potential. And what we really found interesting is that in Austria you don't meet friendly open people that much. Austrians are rather skeptic people. And in Eisenerz, from the beginning, the locals were really open, really friendly, really happy to have us there. We were really surprised. And so things started very well for us. We set up our autonomous space on the train station next to the youth center. We got very involved with the youth center. We got very involved with the locals passing by. It was a very alive spot with all the work of the trains and stuff happening all around us. It was really nice. We felt very much in the middle of things. And what we really liked, that we felt we meet people that really appreciate our views and that really profit from us opening new perspectives for them. And the whole, our host, the Rostfest, who invited us, their activity is supposed to be exactly about that. That's why Rostfest was very happy to have us. So we had a nice week, but then we encountered a real problem, that the contract we had to use this place was actually not a contract for this place, which we knew before, but we had a deal with the organizers that we stay, it will work out. Okay, then the owners of the place came and said, get lost. And the Rostfest kind of also said, more or less, get lost. Or let's say, we will help you. And that led to a very positive movement within the nomadic village. We had a little referendum, a little talk about what we can do. And as Rostfest anyways told us to pack up, they kind of wanted us to pack up and then have a meeting and then be given a spot where we can unpack again, where they maybe underestimated the effort to pack everything up. And then for us it was a bit, if you pack up already, we don't feel really welcome. We just move on, for sure. This year we really saw that this makes sense, because we had a group of people that actually said, no, we don't let them shit on our back, we rather shit on their back, or let's say we make a very Solomonic gesture of just disappearing. And there was a lot of beauty in that. Because I want to go against the general feeling that people have to be strangers on that planet. They maybe have their 50 or 100 square meters of apartment where they have to work already half a month to just pay for it. And that's their space, and as soon as they step out in front of the door, they're in a strange land that belongs to some abstract thing. In Austria it's mostly the state or the church. 19th century, after the time of Romanticism, where they were really dreaming and thinking, oh, the world and everything. Basically, then there is this time of resignation that our dreams don't come true and stuff. And Biedermeier, in the negative sense, is resignation, retreat to your home, and make your little nice mini world at home. In a positive way, it's just these calculations. Okay, I cannot change the whole world. So I'm making my world smaller and smaller, till I'm at this point where I feel, okay, now I can actually gestalt it or change it or make it in a way. So that's the positive interpretation. We work with our surrounding, we put a lot of effort into getting there. We don't profit from it materialistically, we profit emotionally. And so if things emotionally feel wrong, we're gone. And that's the beauty of it somehow. We are, I think, sedentary since 10 or 20,000 years, and for 200,000 years before, we have been nomadic. And I think this is also, you know, when we encounter people, we talk to a human nature. And that's why some people really react very positively.